What is going on, everybody? You got Tone here, and I am back bringing you some more Draft League content. This time, we are in the NPA Minors Semifinals. We are one of the four teams remaining after this long, grueling season has come to a close. We're in the playoffs. We're in the Final Four, like I said. If you guys missed the last week's battle, we played Herohori and the SL Benfica. Came away with a nice 2-0 win, and we are here in the semifinals. And in a rematch, this time we are up against Trev CL, coach of the Houston Toxapexans, from a rematch way back in week number 5, where we came away with a very narrow 1-0 win on the back of our Diggersby. So, not gonna lie, I was really, really... I was happy to be in the Final Four, and like I probably said before, win or lose, whether I make it to the finals or not, I am still very, very happy with how I played, at least for the most part, especially considering this team I got. It's a 24-person league and all that stuff, so I'm really excited to be in the semifinals at the very least, and Trev is no pushover. He is, well, probably one of those underrated people, or like not really that well known, but he is a very, very cool guy, very well respected in my opinion, at least, very chill, and his team is no joke. It kind of reflects Trev as a battler as style goes, but for the most part, he has a very, very threatening team regardless. And it was not easy to prep for him the first time, and to make matters worse, I didn't really get the chance to prep thoroughly for this battle, because at the same time I had final exams, I had other stuff to do in terms of Christmas preparations, excuse me, so it was really, really difficult to actually try to nail down a strategy this time around. So you see our teams on the screen to your right. Trev's team has not changed at all since the get-go. He still has the same 11 Pokemon you see there. And just a recap of what happened last time, or for what he brought the last time, he brought like a bulky Dragon Dance Mega Tyranitar that could have easily swept me if it wasn't for the fact I had Unaware Clef. He had brought Superior, which I believe was a Grassium Z Leaf Storm variant, a Rocky Helmet Zapdos, a Life Orb Mimikyu, Arcanine because he wanted some Volcarona, and he brought Bronzong, which I believe was Stealth Rock plus Future Sight, if I recall correctly. So, and what I brought the last time, I brought Mangalade, which was like a sub bulk up set, if I recall correctly. Clefable was my Stealth Rocker. I brought Choice Scarf Diggersby, a bulky Crobat, if I recall correctly, Taunt Toxic Spike Drapion, and Lantern. And as you see on your screen, yeah, I ended up bringing the exact same 6 Pokemon. Not because I got lazy, I already told you I already had too many stuff to do in real life, so I really couldn't prep or change. I didn't really feel like changing anything. I did actually end up changing a few things about the team, not really much to deter the objective of the team, but I thought from this time around I would make the team a lot more offensively oriented, so that way I don't get blown back by, I'm not set up for like his more passive mons, or I can't break past his bulkier mons, Alolamola, Bronzong, and all that stuff. So I didn't want to be in a position where I'm on the back foot and I can't get out of that hole, and Trev is the type of person that will capitalize on such mistakes, so I have to do my best to try to mitigate those mistakes as much as I can in this rematch, because we did win this the first time, and trying to beat Trev again a second time is not going to be easy whatsoever. So with that being said, we're just going to hop right into the team and see what we brought this time around, which I already told you, it's the same 6 Pokemon, so, but it's a little bit of a variation on most of my sets here. So first set, you see, we have our Drapion here, but instead of Taunt Toxic Spikes, we're bringing SD3 attacks here with Earthquake, Poison Jab, and Knock Off. The last time I brought Drapion, it was it allowed the Tyranitar to get out Dragonantis for free. I did not want that to happen again this time around, so I changed up the set, made it a little bit more offensively oriented, because I do have the opportunity to set up on his more passive stuff. Like Alolamola, the only thing I have to fear from Alolamola is a Scald Burn, but as you'll see, I have Heal Bell on my Lantern, so that's not that big of a deal. Earthquake is there for the Tyranitar, like I said, prevent that from setting up for free. Poison Jet plus Knockoff is just good stab coverage in general. So the EV spread, we are going for maximum bulk here. The speed is enough for his Mega Tyranitar, if I recall correctly. It outspeeds Jolly Mega Tyranitar and everything slower than that. I didn't really care much for Hitmonchan, in the matter of speaking. I think this also outspeeds Hitmonchan, I doubt it, but I didn't really feel like Hitmonchan was going to be coming in the rematch because of the fact that it still has trouble breaking past Clefable, has trouble with Crobat, Musharna, stuff like that. So I wasn't really that concerned about Hitmonchan for the most part. So that's pretty much going to be my Drapion set. Next up, we have our Lantern, which is, again, the same set as I brought the last week. Scald, Volt Switch, Heal Bell, and Toxic. This is just my way of checking his Zapdos. Prevent that thing from Volt Switching for free. I know it gets access to U-Turn, but I'm rather not have myself in a situation where he gets off free Thunderbolts against my team, considering my electric immunity is outside of Lantern is my Diggersby, so had to keep that in mind. Toxic is nice for worrying now, it's bulkier stuff. I can try to Scald Burn the Bronzong, but other than that, everything else is pretty much straightforward. The EV spread is just here to maximize Lantern's bulk on both the physical and the special side, with more towards the special side, like I said, to check stuff like the Zapdos. And to some extent, the Dragalge, although Lantern can't do much to Dragalge with this particular EVs, with this particular moveset, but it can at least pivot in and take a hit if need be. So that is my Lantern. Next up, we have our Clefable here, which protects Stealth Rock and Moonblast with the Defarium Z. I believe I used this to a good success to ensure that Mega Tyranitar did drop to a Twinkle Tackle at about 55%, I believe. I just wanted something that can at least, I didn't want Mega Tyranitar was an issue to the point where I put Therium Z so that way Twinkle Moonblast plus Twinkle Tackle can knock out Mega Tyranitar, barring it's not bulky again. In that case, I would have to get like at least two high rolls because of the sand boosting Tyranitar on special defense. So it's going to be a little bit more of a pain to deal with. So the rest of the EVs, just my way of trying to balance out Clefable's bulk. I believe the HP plus special defense ensures that my Clefable is not too KO'd by Superior's Leaf Storm after Stealth Rock damage, and Sassy Nature with zero IVs and speed to minimize the damage from Bronzong's Gyro Ball. So that is Clefable. Next up is our Crobat here. I ran Super Fang the last time on my Crobat. This time my Crobat has Toxic over Super Fang, because Toxic is nice for the bulkier Pokemon, because Crobat's a poison type, Toxic will not miss, so there will be no hacks in that case. So Taunt Toxic, is my way of dealing with Alolamola. Wearing that thing down is very, very crucial. Roost to keep itself healthy, and Brave Bird for stab coverage. In general, I believe the speed is enough for his fastest Pokemon is a Superior, so I outspeed that and everything below. Non-Scarf. So this is just another check to his physical attackers for the most part. Stuff like Mimikyu, try to keep that thing in check so I don't eat the pressure off of my Clefable. And that's pr- pretty much it for Crobat in that sense. So yeah, so now we move on to our fifth Pokemon, which is the Diggersby, which is, again, Choice Scarf, Earthquake, Fire Punch, Ice Punch, and U-Turn. Don't really need anything else in terms of coverage. This hits everything on his team for at least neutral damage. It has a very solid matchup here. I considered running Agility, but I think that got into the well a little bit too much for Agility Diggersby in the last couple of weeks, so it's going to be a little bit more trickier to actually pull off. So running Adamant, enough speed for Adamant max speed, Mega T-Tar. With Choice Scarf, I outspeed Superior, Smack with an Ice Punch or a Fire Punch. T-Tar, Earthquake, Zapdos, Ice Punch, Mimikyu EQ, Alolan EQ. Like, you pretty much get the idea of the coverage for the Diggersby. So, that's pretty much it for Diggersby. It's just going to be coming in, pivoting, revenge killing wherever it can with its array of coverage options. And lastly, we have our Mega Gallade. I apologize that the sprite's not showing up for these last ones. But I brought Bulk Up Taunt the last time, making it a bulkier variant, but this time wanted to go a little more offensively, so I brought SD3 attacks, took off Taunt, and I put Shadow Sneak, considering I wanted to have the ability to not get revenge killed by Mimikyu if I can bust its disguise. I can also pick off a weakened Mega T-Tar if it already has a Dragon Dance up, so that's also really cool. Drain Punch, keep itself healthy. Zen Headbutt is there for stuff like Zapdos, it's a Dragalge super effectively. And the Hitmonchan, all that stuff. So, I went from bulk to offensive. It's enough speed again for, max speed Mimikyu. I don't remember if it was Adamant or Jolly Mimikyu that's outspeeding, but it's one of those variants. I'm not entirely sure. But that is the team builder for this week. This is the semifinals. Again, like I said, if we win, we make it to the finals for the first time in a long time. And if we lose, it is what it is. We made it to the final four at least, so I'm very happy with that. Again, if you guys did enjoy, leave a like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. I'm going to get the heck out of here. And until the next time, guys, my name is Anthony, aka Tone, and I'm catching you guys on the flip side. Later!